We have a seamstress both in Lincoln and Omaha. Oh shoot. Ding dong.
That's okay. It's all right. Hi, this is Kate with another Wedding Tip Wednesday. I'm here with Tracy with Rhylan Ling. Welcome.
Thank you. Thanks for doing this.
Yes, yeah. Thank you for being a part of our Wedding Tip Wednesday.
Yeah, give us a reason to get out of the house.
Yeah right. For sure. So Tracy, tell me a little bit about your business. Like, how long have you guys been in business and what you guys have to offer, obviously?
Sure, yeah. So Rhylan Ling opened in 2012. We were originally in Regency Mall. And then we moved to this location just over a year ago, last March. So now we're downtown in the Old Market. But yeah, we focus on really style-forward dresses for modern take on bridal, but we really have quite the variety now. We have a good selection from anything from simple to very extravagant and a very broad price range too. We start about $1,500 and then we do go up quite a bit higher than that with some of our designers like Berta that are a little higher end.
Well, I love your space.
Thank you.
I love it's so welcoming.
It feels like an experience,
yes,
up here.
Yeah, it's so comforting. And yeah. I love all the natural light and
Thank you.
The fact how you guys showcase your dresses. It's beautiful.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Yeah, we had a lot of local hands involved up here, actually. Like the racks I designed myself and were done by Steel Creations, which is a local person. And I don't know, we've had lots of local hands touch in here, which is kind of fun.
What is a common question that you guys get asked when somebody's looking to make an appointment?
Sure. I feel like the big question is usually price point a lot. I think the better way to go about it sometimes is to check the designers carried by stores, especially in this area. For the most part, there's exclusivity on different designers in the area. So everybody's going to have a different designer selection from store to store. So it's good to kind of get an idea for what kind of styles a store might have and make sure that aligns with, you know, your personal style. Because at the end of the day, you want a dress that you just love and feel beautiful in, and you want it to feel like a really pretty version of yourself and feel good and comfortable in it. So starting with finding a designer or a store that has designers that really speak to you, I think is a good spot to start.
Sure. How many designers do you guys carry?
We have a lot of diffusion lines in here. So we have a lot of our designers have multiple collections.
Okay.
So I bet we have like 6 designers, but multiple collections from almost all of those designers. So like Haley Page also has Blush by Haley Page, and okay, Made with Love also has Emmy May, and Berta, we have Privé and Muse. Most of the time with those diffusion collections, the collection is trying to focus on a different style of bride or a different price point, just depending on how the designer has it set up.
Okay.
So.
Awesome.
Yeah.
Do you guys do in-house alterations too?
So we try to have a full experience available for brides. So we do everything from all to even like preservation in store. Mm-hmm. However, our seamstresses don't work for me.
Okay.
So they're still private contractors. What we do is we call it a VIP experience, where brides, or all-inclusive experience, if you will, where brides, when they purchase their gown, can decide if they would like to use one of our in-house seamstresses for their alterations. That way we can store the gown for them. They don't have to take it home. And then they make their appointment with the seamstress directly, but they meet them here. Mm-hmm. So their dress, they're never having to shuffle their dress around.
Sure.
And then once it's done with alterations, we have it pressed and ready to go for them. They don't pick it up till the week of their wedding. So that is one option. It's available to pretty much everyone, but our short turnaround brides, sometimes just from an accommodation standpoint, if your dress isn't coming in more than 3 months before your wedding date, it's easier to go to them. So we have a seamstress both in Omaha and Lincoln that have studios set up where they actually have a place for you to go and do your alterations. That's what our brides with a shorter turnaround, or that, you know, don't feel the need for the all-inclusive experience, or live out of state or out of town.
And I also see too that you guys have accessories.
Lots of accessories. Yep, absolutely. I'm kind of an accessory person, so I go a little overboard. Yeah. But yeah, we have a lot. I mean, everything from super blingy, cool stuff from Hope Bride that's made out of Swarovski to like more metalwork stuff. Like, I don't know if the camera's getting this table, but cool metalwork stuff, stuff that can be worn again. And then everything from right now, having a dress that can have two looks is kind of a cool new concept mm-hmm. that we're seeing a lot of brides do. So lots of overskirt options. So, you know, you can do an overskirt over a fitted dress and then take it off after the ceremony and kind of get two looks in one. Veils are really popular right now, like a long, cool, dramatic veil, which mm-hmm. is, I'm sure you love that.
I love that. Yeah. Yes, of course.
For film, it uh-huh. turns out really pretty. Mm-hmm. We also have really expanded our selection of, and we're calling them inclusive size dresses. So dresses in that like 16 to 24 range for sample to try on. Almost all of our designers accommodate sizing, you know, from 00 to, I think most of them go up to a 28.
That's amazing.
But when you don't have them to try on, mm-hmm. it's awfully hard to envision what it might look like yeah. when it fits closer to your body type. So we have almost 30 dresses now in 16 to 22, 24s. We have a few 24s. It's been a nice way for us to expand that experience because we were already seeing brides of all different body types.
Oh, sure.
I always say babes come in all sizes. So, you know, we're already seeing, but having a better selection for them to actually try on has been, it's been a cool expansion.
Can brides book appointments online with you?
So yeah, we definitely do online booking. You can actually see what times are available even. So I know a lot of places offer online booking, but you're just putting in your preferred time of day, you can actually see what the appointment slots available are mm-hmm. on our website, which has always been really beneficial, I think, for brides. Right now, with this crazy time, we're also offering some like virtual appointment stuff. But another thing that we've gotten prepared is we have a bridal portal available now, where once we have you in our system, we can shoot you an email with a link that takes you to your own kind of personal bridal portal. And you can shop our inventory, save things that you definitely want to try on, your favorites, and it bucks it back to our system. So when you come in for your appointment, we already have a pretty good idea of what dresses to pull for you. You know, there'll be some more, we'll still want to talk to you about your overall vision or what you liked about certain dresses, price point, you know, to make sure we're pulling you the best options. But it's a great way for you guys to be able to do something now, you know, while you're at home and while there's less options to shop. It's a bright light, something fun to do. Yeah. Go look at bridal dresses. The plan now is to open back up in May. We're definitely, we were hoping that we could just get back to business as usual, but I think everybody knows that's not going to be exactly how this all happens. So mm-hmm. there'll have to be limitations on guests in the store. You know, we'll have to take precautions. We might need to have our consultants pull all the dresses instead of everybody touching everything and then, you know, having somebody help you change besides our consultant, but then us kind of helping talk you through it just like we always would. But, you know, weird times, weird measures. Yeah. We're still kind of working that out, but right now the plan's to hopefully get back to normal. Not normal, I guess. Open. Get back to open.
Right.
In the next couple weeks. But yeah, until then, and even after the fact, it's cool for the brides to be able to go into their own little virtual mm-hmm. and see the actual dresses we have in the store. Because, you know, you don't have every dress from every designer.
Right.
But there is options to borrow from most of our designers. Just depends on which one. But
what is one tip you would give brides looking for vendors in your category?
Sure. Just stay true to yourself. If you love the dress and you feel beautiful in it, that's what's going to light up, whether it's what you expected to like or something that took you by surprise. I would say stay true to your own sense of style and what you love, because that day you want to put your dress on and just feel amazing in it. And if you're wearing a dress because somebody else liked it or because your group liked it better, it's not going to have the same effect as putting on a dress that you love and really speaks to you.
I'm pretty sure you see this when a bride brings a ton of people with, But do you, would you recommend like brides keeping that number more limited instead of having all these opinions?
Yeah. Unfortunately, for the foreseeable future, I don't think there's going to be much of a choice right sure. now. There definitely for a while, I think in all bridal stores, going to be a limit on how many people you can bring. Now, not to say you can't FaceTime in as many people as you want or do something like that. That's fun too. Mm-hmm. We're thinking about doing celebratory appointments for brides that say yes during this like restrictive time mm-hmm. so that they can come back in the store and still have that experience of having everyone with them. But it just depends on the bride. Some brides, if you're bringing a lot of people with you because you feel obligated to, that's probably not the right decision for you. If you're bringing a lot of people with you because you're somebody who just enjoys the energy of having a lot of people around with your wedding planning, and you don't think that you'll be swayed into a dress that maybe you don't love as much by opinion, I would say, yeah, go for it, you know, once we are able to do that again. But we don't mind big groups at all. It just, it depends on the bride's personality. It really overwhelms some girls, other girls thrive on the energy of having a big group with them.
Sure.
If you're a bride that's easily overwhelmed by high energy, try for a weekday, even a weekday evening. It tends to be a little quieter. We're all about having fun. We're very carefree experience. We want brides to come in here and we want to become your friend and we want to become your confidant when it comes to your wedding planning. Particularly around your dress. We're by no means wedding planners, but we're really good at the dress stuff. But yeah, I mean, we want that feel of everything's taken care of and we're here for you because we are. We really love our brides and you'll get to know us. We have a great, great team here. So you'll get really used to hearing and seeing the same faces. And, you know, when you call, we'll know who you are. And we love that. Just very inclusive feel to the experience, being able to do everything start to finish and really get to know everybody. So
sure. Cool.
Yeah. Awesome.
Well, Tracy, thank you so much for taking time out of your day
yeah.
to get dressed up and stuff and get out of the house.
I know. I got makeup on. I curled my hair. I did it all, Kate.
For brides looking for information, though, where can they find more information about you guys?
Sure. So our website is rhylanlang.com, and I know Rhylan's a tricky one. It's rhylanlang.com. You can probably screw it up a little bit and still find us, which was part of the charm of that. It was actually my maiden name is Rylander, is where all that came from. But that we're also really active on social media. We do a ton on Instagram. It's a great way to kind of get to know us, and we really interact with our brides a lot on there. So we have a good time with it. And if you're not already following us, that's a great way to just kind of see what we're all about.
Awesome. Well, Tracy, again, thank you. And make sure you check back for more episodes on Wedding Tip Wednesday. And Tracy, I really appreciate your time.
Thank you.
Thank you.